Since then, it's something that came out, right? It's a sensitive content, right? I must throw that advisory out there. Now, Russell Simmons has been accused of outwitting and harassing former Def Jam executive in a new lawsuit. Woman said she used a wrestling move to pin her down. Ignored my pleas, right? Chad, this is one day ago. It says neighbors. Russell Simmons might have left the United States, but that isn't stopping those allegations from catching up to him. According to court documents, a woman is alleging that he R-worded her when she worked for Def Jam Recording in the late 1990s. Per the documents, the woman, who is going by Jane Doe, says she visited his apartment to go over editing of a video. She says while there, he did a wrestling move on her, pinned her to the ground, and R-worded her. Now, we know, I don't know about wrestling moves, but we know Russell Simmons does that yoga, right? Chat, y'all know, that's kind of what I touched on in the last stream. Russell Simmons does that yoga. Look, if you guys don't know, let me go pull it up. Because I showed it in the last stream. Let me go pull it up now. Now, wrestling move? I don't know about that. But I know he knows some yoga moves. Alright. Now look. Okay. Apparently this is... Now you guys know Russell Simmons is in Bali, right? He's in Bali, Indonesia? Is that it? Wait. Let's go to this. What's this? Is this new? 2 days ago. Alright. Before we get to that, I want to show you guys some of Russell's moves, right? I'm sorry. I am somebody. I may be unemployed, but I am somebody. I may be unskilled. Okay, maybe it's different in Indonesia, right? They're doing yoga. Maybe some people wear underwear, right? In their yoga class. Okay, cool. They look pretty free spirit. They're bending all the way up, you know, releasing their energy and all that kind of shit, right? Releasing energy. Chat, this is Russell Simmons right here. Why is the man's head that close to your ass? Chat, why you couldn't be behind one of these women over here, right? If I'm doing yoga, all right, let me not use just me. If a man is doing yoga, you wouldn't think he would want to be in a position where it looks like another man's head is up his ass, right? Look at, you would want to be maybe behind a lady. If you're weird enough, okay, cool. You want the lady behind you, right? But you don't want to be full on moony with your ass on the balls, pause, in this guy's face. But here we are with Russell Simmons, right? This is his yoga.
Save me.
Save me. this is sick, man. This is sick. Same beat. This nasty work. This is nasty work. Now he's doing some different moves. Look, some kind of holding the foot kick move. Maybe this is one of the moves that he did on this lady that's accusing him. That's accusing him, right? She says he did a wrestling move on her, pinned her to the ground, and raped her. Excuse me, R-worded her. Now, look, we know he knows some moves, right? But this looks to be a peaceful guy, right? But we'll see what happens with that. It says she claims she begged him multiple times to let her go, but says she couldn't break free because of his weight. This isn't the first time he's been accused of sexual assault. His set of accusations came in 2017 when multiple women accused him of R-wording them. Ironically, the Jane Doe from this current suit says she ran into Simmons at a yoga class in 2023. Now that's believable. In 2023, but where was she then? Was she in Bali? Right? I don't think he's came back to the States. If you ran into him at a yoga class in Bali, Indonesia, then something's up, right? Maybe you placed yourself there. Who knows? Do you live in Bali? Are you hanging out there? Because we know that he's been in Bali for some time now, right? She said Simmons called her name and instructed her to sit next to him and said, What do you think? I'm going to try and F you? She's a Jane Doe, so we don't know actually her name. So it's not like we can even investigate some of the claims she's making, right? But she is making some of these claims. Like this reads, this isn't the first time that he's been accused of some of these things, right? Here we are right here with him, with some more accusations against him.
1991, when she says she ran into Brett Ratner and Russell Simmons at a New York City music video casting call. 34-year-old.
All right. Let's go back a little bit.
Claimed was like a son to him.
Carrie Clausen Caligi was just 17 in 1991 when she says she ran into Brett Ratner and Russell Simmons at a New York City music video casting call. 34-year-old Simmons was already a successful music mogul as founder of Def Jam Recordings.
How's it going?
Ratner was breaking into the music video scene. Caligi says Ratner asked her to join them for dinner, and that Simmons then invited both of them up to his apartment. She says she thought she was going to watch a new music video, but says instead, things took a terrible turn. Caligi says as the video played, Simmons began sexually assaulting her. She says as she was fighting Simmons off, she looked over to Ratner for help. No help came, and Caligi now believes Ratner was in on it. She says Simmons ripped off her clothes, trying to force her to have intercourse while Ratner looked on. Simmons denies it, saying, "I completely and unequivocally deny the horrendous allegations of non-consensual sex against me with every fiber of my being. I know Carrie Clausen Caligi and remember the weekend in 1991 that she has referenced. Everything that happened between us 26 years ago was completely consensual and with Carrie's full participation." Through his lawyer, Brett Ratner told the LA Times he had no recollection of Caligi asking him for help and denied witnessing her protest. At least 14 women have...
Okay. He said he had no recollection of her asking him for help and denied what?
Has put him on blast.
What was that? He denied what? He didn't deny that something happened. Let's see.
Invited both of them up to his apartment. She says she thought she was going to watch a new music video, but says instead, things took a terrible turn. Caligi says as the video played, Simmons began sexually assaulting her. She says as she was fighting Simmons off, she looked over to Ratner for help. No help came, and
Now, if this isn't the Jane Doe, this is strikingly close to her story, right? She said she was at the apartment too, but that they were going to edit a video, right? Chat, a lot of times these people, these monsters and predators, do appear to be completely different in public. A lot of times they want you to look at them and say, nah, this person don't look like he would do something like that. All the time, behind closed doors, that is exactly what they do, right? I'm not saying that here, but this is what a second woman is saying happened.
Liggy now believes Ratner was in on it. She says Simmons ripped off her clothes, trying to force her to have intercourse while Ratner looked on. Simmons denies it, saying, I completely and unequivocally deny the horrendous allegations of non-consensual sex against me with every fiber of my being. I know Carrie Clausen-Caligi and remember the weekend in 1991 that she has referenced. Everything that happened between us 26 years ago was completely consensual and with Carrie's full participation. Through his lawyer, Brett Ratner told the LA Times he had no recollection of Caligi asking him for help and denied witnessing her protest.
Okay. So he said he has no recollection of her asking him for help and denied witnessing her protest against Russell Simmons, right? So is he saying that this happened and she didn't protest against it? Is he saying that Russell Simmons, you know, just ripped off her clothes, just, you know, they were going to edit a video, and he just came up and started, you know, taking her clothes off, but that she didn't deny it? It's kind of a vague statement he made, and I think he probably made that for court reasons. If this comes back up, right, he can say that I never said that it didn't happen. I said that I didn't see her protest, right? I didn't see her say, stop, stop, get off of me, right? That's interesting.
At least 14 women have now publicly accused Brett Ratner of sexual misconduct.
God damn. Wait, so this guy is also accused of sexual misconduct? This is the guy he's hanging with. This is the guy Russell Simmons was hanging with when he's accused of this sexual misconduct. This guy has 14 accused of speaking out against him? Yo, chat, it's a nasty word.
Accused Brett Ratner of sexual misconduct. Ratner's lawyer
Chat, this nasty word. These two together like a team. It's like Batman and Robin. It's like, who got the most accusers? I think Russell Lutho. He's like 17. Maybe 18 with this new one. I think it's like 18 with this new one. He up. He has 14. Right? Maybe he has some new ones. We don't know. It's like Batman and Robin of sexual accusations. Chat, this nasty word.
Historically denies all of the claims.
And now in an exclusive interview, I am...
All right. Now, this is Kimora Lee Simmons. Now look, Kimora Lee Simmons has something to say, right? This was after this accusation came out, accusation we just watched. I think this came out in 2018. Kimora Lee Simmons said, I add my voice to the chorus of those speaking out against harassment and violence in all its forms. Lee Simmons, 42, wrote in a lengthy Instagram post defending her husband while supporting the Me Too movement on Thursday. I have known Russell for over 25 years. We were close friends. Married, divorced, and have remained friends, co-parents, and partners throughout it all. These allegations against him are nothing like the person I have known in all that time. I have known him to be a caring and supportive father and someone who has worked tirelessly to uplift disenfranchised communities, she added. Continuing her statement, Lee Simmons added, this is a pivotal moment in which men are being held accountable for their abuses of power and denigrating behavior towards women in all spheres. As a mother of two daughters, I believe that no one should ever be shamed or portrayed as an unreliable witness to their own experience for speaking up, nor should anyone be condemned legally without due process and a fair trial. So she's saying, Russell Simmons should not be condemned legally without due process and a fair trial. But she's also saying that she believed that no one should be shamed or portrayed as an unreliable witness for their own experience for speaking up, right? She says, my sincere hope is that anyone faced with harassment or assault reports it to their organization and or law enforcement, though I understand that in many cases this may not be possible. I remain committed as always to fighting injustice and inequity in all its forms. God bless, she concluded. All right, so this is in 2018. She was defending her husband. This is around the time, remember, if you don't know, Russell Simmons met Kamora Simmons when, I want to say she was very young. She was either 16, 17, or 18 when he met her, or, let's see. Let's check that, chat. Russell Simmons marries Kamora Lee Age. Let's see. She was allegedly 15 and 16, the latter was in his 30s. Let's see. Okay. Let's see. Okay, so age gap of 17 years, 22. I want to see when they got married. What age was she? The high-profile romance between Kamora Lee and Russell Simmons started when she was allegedly 15 to 16. The latter was in his 30s. I speak to Vlad TV in 2018. A journalist named Tour said that Lee was just a teenager when she crossed paths with Simmons and began dating. Okay, so he began dating her when she was in high school, when she was 15 or 16. This is her. That's not her. But this is her. Around that age, this is her at 15, I think, and she's speaking on the industry.
Interview, check this out.
She's only 15 years old and is the toast of the international high fashion world. And this gorgeous 6-foot-tall model leads a double life. Part of the time, she's that real-life Cinderella who dresses up for the ball. But back home in St. Louis, Missouri, she's 10th grade student Kamora Perkins.
The gorgeous gown, it's easy to get wrapped up in it. But no, it didn't overtake me because I knew I still had to take off the gown and come home and go back to school. So it was easy to keep my feet on the ground.
Kamora spends 12 weeks out of the school year away from home working in Europe and New York for the likes of Chanel and Yves Saint Laurent. Although she won't turn 16 until next May, she's remarkably mature and says that she's able to keep her distance from the darker undersides of her seemingly glamorous profession.
People get caught up on mental and psychological trips and they get into things like drugs and alcohol, and they're dating people to get certain places. And some people get really confused as to why they're there. There's a lot of things like that going on. Do this, this will make you better, this will make you prettier, this will make you feel good, and when you're stressed out, drink this, this will make you feel, oh God, you have to really watch out for that. They don't know how old I am when they approach me. I'm not a 19-year-old, 21-year-old person. And I have been that are 40 years.
Okay, it's not that she was very smart though. Right? As a young girl, it seems like she was very smart. She was 15 here. She's 15. She was a sophomore in high school. This is her speaking on the industry. This is, I want to say, close to around the time Russell Simmons started dating her, but it may have been shortly after this video, right? They're saying the age was between 15 and 16 when he started dating her.
Years old that want to take me out to dinner, and it's just not something that I need to be seen even in right now.
Back in August of this year, Uncle Rush called.
All right. I don't know, man. Like I said, he is hiding out in Bali, Indonesia. They don't have an extradition treaty with the U.S. So, I think, it seems to be that's one of the reasons he's there. So if he ever is charged with something, He can live it up in Bali doing his yoga shit like fucking all day long, right? He won't be able to be extradited back to the U.S. While all these accusations have came out against him, he's never been prosecuted in the U.S. So this is still like very interesting, right? Maybe he has all his T's crossed and his I's dotted. But this just all seems very weird to me.
To the left, to the left.
It's just a lot of bending and stretching going on and just sweating and just nastiness, man. It's just, I mean, who knows? A lot of these women these days come out with these stories and these, just gross, man. Just gross. A lot of these women come out with these stories and these accounts of what happened or didn't happen. And while a lot of it may not be true, Chad, there are a lot of victims out there that have, has had some bad encounters with some of these men in power, right? And it's just weird to me that he would flee all the way to Bali, Indonesia to be fucking stretching in a sweaty shop with a bunch of men that's dressed in underwear, leopard print underwear, right? So yeah, we'll see what comes from that. But not only that, his children too. Like, if you don't know, like look, this is his daughter here. Apparently speaking on some accounts, she's talking about her dad here. Aoki Lee Simmons. Like I said, he's been in Bali, Indonesia, so he hasn't been around his children for some time. I'm not sure they've seen him for some time. She says on the video that you know, she follows him or followed him. They speak sometimes, but I'm sure this is probably hard for them too, dealing with something like this, you know, accusations like this against your dad. I mean, I don't know how I would deal with something like this. It's got to be hard for it, especially a young woman, right? Because these are other women that are speaking out. But let's check this out.
Industry, because I shouldn't have to lie or be by a child. I have made so much effort with my dad. I will release my entire like WhatsApp log. I'm proud of how I've behaved. I have said I love you, happy Father's Day, whatever. I know things are tough right now, but you know, I will release the whole thing. I'm proud of how I behaved. I've asked for space or for boundaries. I've said, please don't post pictures of mom when you guys are disagreeing. It's like taunting her. Please don't post random baby pictures of all of us together when you guys are in legal issues. Like, and this all started because he's got folks talking about my sister, and you guys know me. You don't talk about my sister. That's when I ended. I only follow him because I was in the media and I had no choice because it was like, why is it? I've been trying not to have drama. So I follow him and I try to be peaceful and I say I love you and happy Father's Day when I can. But I mean, this man has left me stranded in a foreign country. As a minor, he cut off like my debit card and didn't tell me. I'm in Greece, like doing a school trip. I realized all of a sudden I had no money. I go to my teacher, I'm like, my debit card doesn't work suddenly. I don't know what's going on. My mom sent me some money, whatever, but like, he does really vindictive stuff like that. He'll cut you up out of nowhere. He'll cut off your healthcare. He'll cut off your phone bill out of nowhere. Like, you'll be a minor just because you disagree or you say, don't call my mom all these names. And I don't like to have drama. I want to be a peaceful person. There's so...
Okay, what she's speaking on definitely seems kind of controlling, right? It's hard to understand some of this because I don't have daughters, right? But if I did have daughters and you have that kind of status, no need to cut anything off, right? What's done is done. Obviously, her mom does have money, but I don't see the point. You know what I mean? Maybe she's not listening. Maybe she's doing some things you don't like. But Russell, if you're way in Bali, Indonesia, because you know that you've done some things that the world probably don't like, and probably that you don't even like, I don't see why you would cut your own daughter's resources off because she may be doing some things that you don't like or saying some things you don't like, right?
Much that I want to do in the world on my own as my own self, but I cannot just let you taunt me about my mother. And if he says one thing and disagrees with me, I will post it all because he does it. I have videos of him saying awful things that no one should have to hear about anyone they know, much less their mother.
Okay, so this is messy. It's probably obviously texting her things about Kimora Lee, right? But he's angry too, right? This is Russell right here. If you don't know, Kimora Lee had remarried, right? She married this guy, but apparently, after she married him, this guy pleads guilty in a $1 billion monitoring case, right? So she breaks up with Russell Lee. After a while, she gets remarried. I'm not sure if this is their baby, right? Did they have a child together? But it turns out, in a bombshell, this guy has been laundering, right? I know she's like, man, this is all so crazy for me. But apparently, that's one of the reasons that Russell was mad. He's saying that Kimora Lee stole somewhere in the amount of $800 million from him, right? In stocks, and gave it to her new husband, right? To bail him out of his legal troubles, right? This is her new husband, Russell Lee Simmons, or Russell Simmons, is saying that she stole money from him, right? In the amount of $800 million to bail out her husband, right? Because he pled guilty to fraud. He pled guilty to laundering, right? Here's Russell Simmons speaking on that.
Like as a partner in marriage. I must have been a partner of what I hear. No, I was very generous and tried to be supportive. We were together 15 years, Kimora and I. And for 8 years, we were married. Another 7 before that, we were back and forth.
Okay, another 7 before that. So you said 8 years they were married. Another 7 before that. Let's break down the math. Okay, if you met her around 15 or 16, let's say, we're going to change that. Let's say 16, right? Still underage. Let's say you met her at 16. It's still underage in some states. In some states, 16 is age of consent, right? So let's say you met her at 16. 7 years from 16 would be 22? 23. 7 years from 16 to 23. So that means they would have gotten married around between 23, 24, right? Between 22 and 24 years old.
And then I was best friends with Kimora throughout the entire raising of my children. I'm the godfather to all three of her other children. I was good friends with Jaimin. I was good friends.
Wait, so she has three other children? Chad, this is what I mean. That's why it looks a little weird. This guy's sitting like he's fucking Gandhi with his hat on backwards. Right?
With this Tim Leisner. So I tried to be as flexible and as...
you definitely try to be flexible.
Accommodating and supportive. And then, you know, sometimes things don't work out. You've seen there's a lawsuit. I had no choice. I think Jesus Christ, Muhammad, Lord Buddha, anybody would have sued. What? It's a lot of money and it can help a lot of people. She gave what is now, today, based on the stock, $800 million to the government illegally. And now I'm fighting to get my half of it back. And it was in support of Tim, who, as you know, is a convicted criminal. And they stole, I think it was $6 to $8 billion from the Malaysian people. And his bail was my stock, which had no right to be.
Kimora alleges that you didn't use any of your own money to buy the stock. You didn't use
Tim paid for
own,
stock.
Own
Tim,
money to Tim bought the stock. Invest in her investment company?
Of my company. Tim put money in my company and we bought the stock. It's obvious. The government will figure that out. It was mine. I found the company. I built the company. I reformulated the drink. I got LeBron and Kobe and Kim Kardashian and Puffy and everybody to promote it. It was nothing. And now it's worth $16 billion, right? And I was part of that process. In fact, it would never have existed if not for me. That's a fact. So I did the work, and I own the stock.
Okay. So it looks like Russell's on his business, though, right? I don't know about the sexual accusations, but I know as far as his business, it looks like he's still on his business, right? She may have stole $800 million from him. Well, $800 million. But to him, it doesn't seem to hurt him, right? He just said he has a company that's worth $16 billion, right? All right. I don't know, chat. We'll see what happens with the accusations against him. This is Kimora right here. We'll take it out with this. It says, Kimora Lee Simmons exposes Russell for being a broke Debbie who's hiding. Let's check some of this out.
And raise that. So you guys know my kids. My kids have worked at the UN. My kids are ambassadors of the world. My kids speak multiple languages. Like I said, my youngest daughter is... we're not going to get into all of our tech gadgets, but what was I saying? So you all know that my kids are not brainwashed. Those of you that know me here also know what kind of parent I am. I have been a parent pretty much all my life. I was a very young, probably too young bride. So I had these kids very early.
Here you go, chat. You know the tears gotta come at. Now, chat, look, with all due respect to Kimora Lee Simmons, right? Not taking away from any of her experiences. Chat, queens, respectfully, we know there's two things a woman's gonna do after a breakup, right? She's either gonna say he abused her, right? Well, three things. She's gonna say he abused her, he hit her, he abused her emotionally, some kind of abuse, right? She's gonna say he's gay, right? That's something women say. Or she's gonna show some tears, right? That's what she's doing here. This is the sympathy move, right? I can't necessarily call this a sympathy move, right? Because we don't know what she's experienced with Russell Simmons. And I'm sure it's probably been turbulent. But here comes the tears.
A barrage of... probably too young... bride. So I had these kids very early, and you guys know how much my family means to me, and you know how much my kids mean to me, and you guys know, all of you that know me absolutely know what kind of mother I am and what kind of family dynamic I have over here. I think it's very important for you all to know if you look back in our history, I have always been the type of co-parent. You know, we were actually very famous for our co-parenting abilities and, you know, how we always put the good face forward and the good foot forward to the...
All right, we're going to play this, but shout out to Kimora Lee Simmons. She still has that name, by the way, or did she change it when she got married? Either way, shout out to her. I think she's a very smart woman, man. I feel for her. I think she's a very smart woman, and it seems like she got away from him early on, right? It seems like they speak on this co-parenting thing, right? Which means, like, she got away from him early on, and they just did the co-parenting thing. But obviously she was at a wit's end with that. And probably with some of the accusations that's come to a head. Obviously, Russell Simmons flee to Bali, Indonesia to do yoga all day and run his company from afar, right? Yeah, chat. I don't know. it's falling apart slowly, right? Who knows? Maybe you can run to Bali, but your problems will they still come to light, right? I don't know. This is messy, man. Shout out to this family chat. I hope it all works out, right? I hope Kimora and her daughters get the peace that they're looking for. All the victims, if there are any victims, right? Russell Simmons has not been convicted. I don't know if he's even been charged with anything, right? We know he's been accused, but I don't know if he's been charged. We know he definitely hasn't been convicted of anything. But to any victim that may have experienced anything at the hands of Russell Simmons, my condolences to you, and I hope you get the justice that you deserve. All right? Okay, chat. Let's move on.